million gallons of oil. 1.6 million gallons of oil spilled in the Atlantic Ocean. This can take 6 months and millions of dollars. This oil spill is one of the worst oil spills in the world. Luckily, the ship didn't spill 20 million gallons of oil, but only 1.6 million gallons of oil. But it killed about 20,000 ocean animals and counting. Other animals are suffering badly and have died. This is very sad for the ones who have to see these animals suffer. Now back to you, Kyle.
Excellent report, Ben. It's too bad about the oil spill. Now we'll go to see the Emerson with the boat from there.
Thanks, Kyle. In South Burlington, certain small tractors now have remote-controlled robots built into their backs. These machines are being used by the U.S. Air Force personnel all over the world. The reason that the U.S. Air Force is using remote-controlled tractors is to clear minefields and any other explosives still on the ground that have not been set up. $3.5 million will be used to build the next set of landmine clearing robots. The machines could also help fight the war on terrorism, explained Dr. Blakey. These robot mine-moving tractors also provide welcome jobs for people who know about high-tech things and were laid off. 22 jobs have been added this year, which makes the total of 57. And more jobs are expected to become available. Back to you, Kyle.
Very interesting, Katie. Now we'll go to Dean with the latest in sports.
Thanks, Kyle. I'm going to be talking about Michael Jordan's Wizards ripping the Bucks. The Washington Wizards crushed the Bucks last night, 103-78. Michael Jordan, who started in his second game in a row, scored 25 points in 30 minutes of play. The player he replaced was Brian Russell. He scored a career-high 16 points in their win off the bench. After this win, the Wizards end a 6-game losing streak, putting their season's record at 7-10. This has effect on Michael Jordan's last season as trying to beat Wilt Chamberlain's career points average. He will be trying to beat 30.6 career average points. If everything goes to plan, Michael Jordan will be beating them. This also has effect on the Wizards and their chances of getting into the playoffs, because if Michael Jordan keeps on playing like this, then they'll probably get more wins and they'll probably see the playoffs. Back to you, Kyle. And have you been working out?
It's hard to believe Jordan is still so good. Now we'll have a short commercial break. When we return, we'll have Dana Gerard will cover school news, Stephen Fulton will cover national, and I will be getting you the weapon.
What's that? All the proactive spray. But fans are headgear. Most wear them for the fashion, but here at Kleenex, we have decided on the latest of tactical tissue use and fashion.
You see the players at the foul line, sweat dripping off their faces and nerves hitting hard. Kleenex understands that sometimes people need the extra protection when it comes to a runny nose.
I'm in the game yesterday. Down by 1 point, I had to take 2 foul shots, and I have a cold. Oh, I got the urge to sneeze. Swish! Oh, this Kleenex headband just did me good. Got one more shot to win the game. Oh, I got the urge again. Two! Oh, that floor doesn't need cleaning because of this Kleenex headband.
I remember the playoff line.
Alright. Just from all you guys out there trying to buy the new and improved headbands, remember, Kleenex tissues, the pros wear them. This is from Karl Malone, Shaquille O'Neal, Steve Francis, and Kobe Bryant.
You need them.
Oh.
Welcome back to the Catalan News. Dan and Gerard will now talk about school news.
Thanks, Bob. A new way of football is being introduced to the 6th grade students. On Tuesday, December 3rd at recess, our assistant principal, Mrs. Stebbins, announced that whomever was interested in playing was to go to Mr. Rosham's class to hear the rules and sign up. The players now will be chosen by two captains that can only be picked as a captain for one day. Then a new one will be picked. This may be a good way to spend your recess, but a bad time to cause trouble. That's you, Kyle.
Very interesting, Dana. Jeff Important is here now with the national news.
Thanks, Kyle. Governor Howard Dean went to Israel to meet and talk with the president of Israel on Monday. They talked about the presence of Palestinian Arafat. Dean said that we can't make peace with Arafat because it's my assessment that terrorism is an enormous problem here. And no peace is going to be made as long as terrorism is going on. I feel this could affect the United States because President Bush has a strong policy of terrorism. If President Arafat does not change his terrorism policy, it might force the U.S. to the United States to take action. Now, back to you, Kyle.
Nice work, Stephen. Now it's time for the weather report with me.
Okay. In New York, the high is 35 and the low is 23. In Canada, the high is 65 and the low is 47. In Montana, the high is 51 and the low is 34. In Hinesburg, Vermont.
Kyle, what are you doing? Hines is right here. You're from Hinesburg. What are you doing?
In Hinesburg.
No, the high is 30.
And the low is 23. And in Boston, the high is 34 and the low is 25.
Thank you, Kyle.
Okay, we're at Catamount News. Thank you for tuning in.
And that's all, folks.
Then, with no time remaining on the clock, Cleveland quarterback Tim Couch dropped back to pass. He threw a 50-yard touchdown pass to Quincy Martin. This tied the game, and the win was up to the Cleveland kicker. He rose to the occasion and split the uprights and received 1 point. The Cleveland players and fans went nuts as the Browns won one of their most crucial games of the season. A still greater comeback happened on Saturday night when the Lakers shocked the Mavericks in NBA action. Coming back from a fourth quarter 27-point deficit, the defending champion Lakers came into the game with only a 7-13 record. They faced the 17-1 first-place Dallas Mavericks. The Lakers started out terribly, and it wasn't until the fourth quarter when they got hot. They outscored the Mavs 44-15 on 16 of 18 shooting in the final quarter. The second greatest comeback of all time was led by Kobe Bryant, who scored 21 of his 27 points in the fourth quarter. Back to you, Melissa.
Thanks, Jacob. Going right back after a short commercial break. When we return, we will be hearing about school news, national, and Astro League against the weather. So stay tuned.
Consider paperless card, energy products. Breaking your teeth? Well, we here at Candy Co. Industries have got energy products for you. Introducing the Versa Cane, a dynamic energy source that sends power to you every lick.
Man, I'm tired. I wish I had more energy.
Here, try these. Candy Co. Industries new.
Chocolate, Super Mint, and Brussels sprouts. My favorite. Peace out, dude.
Yay!
Yeah.
Come back. Time out
late.
In school, what a week with busy week we've had. Loads of music on Tuesday with the 56th grade students preparing for their concert. Wednesday, these very hardworking students performed to stay hosting second grade classes early in the morning. Later that evening, they performed for their parents. What a wonderful job they did. Thursday, students were visited by an African woman who owns a store in Charlotte called Authentic Africa. She is from Africa and goes back once or twice a year to collect more items to sell. She encourages students to visit. Also, 5-6 councils announced they are planning a dance. The date has not yet been decided, but everyone seems excited. And as we know, the holiday season is coming. The Catamount team has decided to do community service. $100 has been divided between two families. We have also decided to sponsor a dog at a local no-kill animal shelter, but have not agreed yet how much money to give. Would you be willing to give us some national news?
Yeah, Melissa. $300 billion.